5 basic things in C++ that you might not know. Hello everyone. Let's move to our first topic. That is, there are common misconceptions that you can only use Boolean operations inside the brackets of an if statement, which is not true. As we see over here, I have used a Cout statement in the brackets of an if statement. This Cout statement is executed at the same time this if statement is executed, and this if statement yields false because of the exclamatory point, and thus the else part is executed, and thus we get IEEE and the student branch Pune as our output on the terminal. Let's see if we get the output correct. So we just got some unused variables warning. That is fine, that's not an error. So we get IEEE student branch Pune as the output. Let's move on to the second topic then. I'll just remove the comments. Our second topic is, I have first initialized two variables, s1 and s2, one with string data type and the other with char, and I have written strlen for calculating the length of both the strings. Now this, we should get an error for this, because we cannot use strlen for a string data types variable. Strlen works only for char data type. So let's see if we get an error. Yes, we get an error. So what we can do is, we'll just remove strlen and we'll use length or size function. I'll use here length. You can use either length or size. So this here should give me a proper output. This should not give me an error. Did not give me an error. Now I'll get the size of both the strings. Yes, I got the size of both the string hello, 5 and 5. This is just the output of the previous snippet. Let's move on to the third topic. Here I have, what I have done is, I have used something other than equal to operator to compare two variables. So what I have done is, I have used XOR operator. Now the way XOR operator works is, if you get the same values, that is, it works on binary basically, and so when you get 1 1, you get a value output as 0. So that is what we want to target. So I have used this power operator for XOR, and I have initialized X and Y to 10, so the same values, right? So when I do an XOR, I'll get an output as 0, that is false, but because of this exclamatory, I'll get output as this statement. So I should get X is equal to Y as the output for this snippet. So let's just see if we get that. Yes, so we get the correct output. These are the outputs of the previous snippets, and this is the output that we got, X is equal to Y. So we can use something other than equal to operator to compare. That's just one interesting fact. Let's move on to the fourth. If we say that M and P both are integers, and integers occupy 2 bytes on our memory, how much space do you think these will occupy? If you think that it is 4, then it is wrong, because unless and until you assign value to the M variable, this won't occupy any space in your memory. When you assign value to it, it does occupy some space. So this whole
statement would occupy only 2 bytes on your memory. Alright, now let's move on to the fifth one, the last one. So what this fifth one is that I have used a right shift operator. This is something we used when we use CN, right? But this is something different. The operator is same, but this here we have used to shift the number in its binary form to two digits right. So what happens here is, if I take a variable like a value of 4, here I have taken 4, right? So binary of 4 is 100, and when I shift it to right, that is I am removing the rightmost two digits, that is 00, what I get is 1. This is equivalent to dividing the number by 4. Now you would say that I have written here 2, but how is it dividing by 4? So what it does is, this is shifting it by 2 bits. So if I mention 3 over here, I'll just shift it by 3 bytes, and this would actually be division by 8. Similarly, 4, it's division by 16, and so on. Let's just see if we get the division by 4 correct. There's no error, and what we get over here is, yeah, so this is the outputs of, these are the outputs of the previous snippets, and one we get as the output of our fifth snippet. So that's all for this video. Thank you.